All systems operating within normal design parameters.
Really alone. And I know that I feel the same way about you today as I did the day I said I do.
She just wanted to talk to you, Randy. She wanted you to know how she felt.
Shivani and Dusty Rhodes, and welcome to WCW Saturday Night, 1 week away now from Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. The worst thing that could possibly happen has happened to the Macho Man Randy Savage. He walks out, he's upset from comments made by Miss Elizabeth. Very sincere comments, I would think.
Well, I tell you what, Tony, it was an emotional roller coaster ride for the Macho Man Randy Savage. I thought it had all been behind him after the scene in the hallway of the hotel. But on this past Monday Night Raw, Macho Man Randy Savage was face to face with what I believe is reality. Whether he will be ready for Halloween Havoc, I have no idea, but we will speculate on it and give you my take on it tonight on Saturday night.
As a matter of fact, we will show you that interview conducted by Eric Bischoff and hear the comments from Miss Elizabeth. Our first match in the ring, Diamond Dallas Page, one-on-one against Scotty Riggs. Before we go there, here are some comments from his opponent at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, Eddie Guerrero.
Diamond Dallas Page, you know, I gotta say something. Beating you for the ring, that was a great accomplishment for my career here in WCW. But you had to go and make it personal, trying to hurt my neck and trying to hurt my nephew. And if you think that I'm gonna let you run over the Guerreros, well, you're in for a surprise, baby, because come Halloween Havoc, you better get ready for a war.
Self-high five.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Las Vegas, Nevada, DDP, Diamond Dallas Page.
It's Eddie Guerrero and Diamond Dallas Page coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. And here he is, Diamond Dallas Page Dream. And can you believe it? It is almost here, 8 days away now from Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc.
Yes, it is. There's so much excitement going on in this arena on the mothership here on Saturday night. The Macho Man, Randy Savage. Here, is he physically here? Emotionally, I know he's gone. I blame. I'm gonna give you a take on something that you ain't gonna like because we're to blame. That's what happening with Macho Man Randy Savage. I'm talking about us, reporters are.
His opponent, accompanied to the ring by his American Males tag team partner, Marcus Bagwell. He's from Atlanta, Georgia, Scotty Riggs.
Well, Dream, I gotta ask, as we see Scotty Riggs with Marcus Bagwell coming out, I gotta ask, talking about?
Well, what I'm talking about real quick, because I'm going to philosophize on it all night long, because past Monday Nitro, when you take a man, if I was to bring you, Tony, and dig on you with a knife and throw you up in front of a monitor, just because I wanted to have some type of report going on, then I guarantee if I drug your laundry in the street about you and Lois and say, look here on the monitor in front of millions of people, and you got emotionally upset, I would just the blame. As the NWO, how high does the NWO go here in WCW? What I'm saying is, I think there's somebody more important than we've seen on television running their home base. That's all I'm saying. Could be here in the booth, could be here in the arena. That's all I'm saying.
Now, well, those are some accusations flying
out
here.
But I wanted to get them out. I wanted to get him out.
Well, I don't think there's any question, fans, that what happened to the Macho Man Randy Savage, and we will see in its entirety later on in the telecast, what happened to the Macho Man was of the worst timing ever.
Yeah, that's more or less what I said.
Yeah, that's more or less what you said.
Yeah, he was getting ready.
I just kind of put it in a briefcase instead of the suitcase.
Yeah, but
he,
Tony, he was getting ready to go to match, right? And he kind of settled down from that thing in the hotel room.
Yes.
And all of a sudden we said, hey, come here.
Take a look at this, and there he goes.
Yeah, and he tried to get away. We said, no, you got to watch this.
Yeah.
And here's your ex-wife crying on the plane.
Boy, she was.
And I mean, just the bawling. And I'm going to tell you what, she looks sincere, but I got the question, is this another plot by the NWO just to really take him out of the match? I guess it's getting too close for this to keep going on.
I don't think there's any denying there is a plot by Diamond Dallas Page. And that plot is to try to embarrass Eddie Guerrero, which he pretty much succeeded in doing. If you'll recall, back in August here on TBS with the Quacks as the champion, he still has the Battle Bowl ring. He denies that, but he and Eddie in a return match for the Battle Bowl ring coming up next Sunday at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc.
Well, you know, we got all this stuff out of the way right here at the start, and we are missing a good match right here, because I'm going to tell you something about Dallas Page. He's another guy that got into some people's family. He drove the Guerrero family out in the street, literally by the hair, the head, and now then he claims that he will end the Guerrero's reign as a family of great wrestlers comes to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, WCW, Las Vegas, Nevada. We're both going to be there. That remains to be seen. He's having a problem right here with Scotty Riggs. Well, Scotty Riggs having a problem with Dallas.
Well, most people have, because Diamond Dallas, like him or not, and most people do not, starting with me, Diamond Dallas is the type of guy who knows how to wrestle. There's no doubt about it. He has studied the sport. He knows what he's doing in the ring. Look at this. Oh! The Diamond Cutter is awesome, but there's more than just the Diamond Cutter dream.
Yes, there is. And
there's a cover. One, yeah. Two. Got it.
And he knows what to do, when to do it, and how to do it, and how to agitate guys like you and agitate his combatants that is in there with here on the mothership here on Saturday night on TBS. But I guarantee you one thing, the Guerreros, my home is, he's going to be ready for this thing. He's going to be ready for a war, and it will be a war out there. There are fights going on. There are fights going on in Las Vegas, and we're going to be right on top of it.
We are going to be right there, and there goes Scotty Riggs. From the inside going out, down to the floor, Scotty Riggs, Sunday Diamond Dallas Page back in. We're going to be right in the midst of it at the gorgeous MGM Grand in the Garden Arena coming up next Sunday, 8 o'clock Eastern Time is the time. Will the NWO succeed? They've been successful so far. We will find out next Sunday up on top. And here goes Scotty Riggs over the top. Sunset flip, cover one, two, and did not get him.
I thought he had him. Had him hooked up.
Nick Patrick still favoring the neck.
What neck?
The neck on his head.
Oh, man, I'm going to tell you, you talk about a turkey neck. Nick Patrick, one day he's got a neck brace. Next day, don't you talk to him on his back. Oh, Diamond Cutter. Put out the light. This part is over.
The Diamond Cutter from the ropes. One, two, three. The foot is under the rope. The foot was under the rope.
Yeah, well, that's your man.
That's not my man.
Yeah, because every time you get a chance to talk to him, and I tell you to ask him in coach questions.
I did. I accused him Monday night of being the mass referee on the NWO segment. Did you not see that?
Yes, okay. Of course I've seen that.
All right.
Of course I've seen that. But don't filibuster tongue with me.
Right.
Anyway, we off to a bang here.
I'm going to go see Diamond Dallas.
Go talk to
him.
Here's
our Babylon High Performance Move of the Week.
Yeah, well, I guarantee you one thing. Dallas will be ready for Eddie Guerrero. But more than that, Eddie Guerrero and the Guerrero family and pride, speaking of WCW with a big card play, will be ready for here. Diamond Dallas Page possesses what I think is the most devastated hold here in the 90s. It's called the Diamond Cutter. You see it right there. That was your Babylon High Performance Move of the Week. Used by America's top mechanic. People are known. Use Babylon. Talk to that old Dallas there. Show a tongue, Tony. Hey, Tony, ask him. I'll ask him.
All right, Dream, let's bring him in right now. He wins once again with a Diamond Cutter, Diamond Dallas. Hey,
Tony, did you see that? Did you see that? Scotty Riggs was rocking DDP all over the place, but he made one mistake. And that's all it take. Bada bing, Diamond Cutter. Something that Senor Eddie Guerrero, he knows very well.
And something, Dallas, I believe does not bother him, because he is ready for next Sunday night and his chance to get maybe that Battle Bowl ring again at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc.
Whatever, the ring he wasn't man enough to walk out with at the Clash of Champions. Now, who knows where it is? But the way DDP sees it, at Halloween Havoc, at the MGM Grand, in DDP's home away from home, Las Vegas, Nevada, Senor Eddie, I hope you like the music, because Burrito Boy, I'm gonna be playing La Bamba with your head on the turnbuckles, and I'm gonna be smacking you around like a piñata doing the Macarena. And then, only because you know it so well, I'm going to reintroduce you to my little friend, the Diamond Cutter. Bang!
Diamond Dallas awaits Eddie Guerrero next Sunday, and we'll be back on Saturday night.
But all I know is that I'm sitting here in this place where we used to share everything, in the swing that you built for me. And I'm alone again.
Match is coming up. It's Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc Cruiserweight Championship. Rey Mysterio Jr. against former champ Dean Malenko. A special look at the Cruiserweight champ, Rey Mysterio Jr. Next Sunday at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. I tell you, Dean Malenko and Rey Mysterio Jr., the Cruiserweight title match should be as intense as anything you will find in our sport.
You know, Tony, as I see it, there are fights going on. That is a fight. Hall and Nash, the outside of the Harlem Heat's a fight. Hogan and Savage, that's a fight. And I guarantee you there are winners in fights. This man right here has got the mask of Rey Mysterio Jr. that he took violently on the set while you were interviewing him as you throwed his coat across his head to keep a nation from seeing this young man noggin. And now then, what has happened on the transpire side is, he say you want it back, the mask come and get it. Well, Rey's gonna come after it, I can't hear. That's my filibuster on that.
Alex,
he wasn't ready for all that, but I gave it to you.
Boy, he's not kidding. That made it sound a lot better than it was, actually.
Well, it was. You just,
it was a horrible thing. Yeah, it happened.
I would hate to have you at a five. I was on five. Somebody said, throw your sport coat on me and stomp a mud hole in me to get the fire. Man, I'm telling you, laid it on him like it, you know, like it was a come on a car wreck.
I'd be more willing to stomp a mud hole in you. I can tell you that.
Oh, my Lord. I hope my mama ain't listening.
In the midsection, here is Dean Malenko.
The one of Ken. The Germany's own right here. Everybody in Germany will be watching the Wonder Kid, but boy, he got it working out for him right here. Because as you said, Dean Malenko, she won't take no for an answer.
Over the top, here he goes. It's Dean Malenko. Oh, spinning sidekick, nicely done. And an arm drag takedown. You know, Dusty, here is Alex Wright, who recently on Nitro upset Dean Malenko. Dean Malenko was upset weeks gone by Brad Armstrong recently. Got a little bit of revenge when he defeated him on Nitro this past Monday. So this is a very important match for Dean Malenko. He will not look past Alex Wright looking ahead to Rey Mysterio Jr.
I don't think he was looking past Alex Wright when Alex Wright got the victory either. I think Alex Wright has really come into his own. That's what we're talking about. Anybody can be beat at any time. Anytime there's a fight, a wrestling match going on here at WCW where the big boys play here on Saturday night, especially the mothership. And Alex Wright knows now that he's about to get his leg broke, but he understands how to beat this guy. Once you beat somebody, you know what I mean? You got that embedded in your noggin of how it's done. So that's what makes this match up.
We still have to come in this telecast, the Macho Man Randy Savage going up against a gigantic man that we've never seen before.
Who is that?
Called Roadblock.
Roadblock. Well, just the words alone tell me there's going to be something going on.
He's
because
a big one.
If you say, if you're in the car, like me and you driving the other night, we were going to that bar, that place. We're going to that place, and you said, there's a roadblock in the head. I stopped, okay? Well, right here, will the Macho Man stop before he gets to the ring with his roadblock, keep him from getting the WCW Slim Jim Halloween Havoc? That's the question to ask you.
I think there's more than just the man named Roadblock in his way.
Yeah, there's a lot of emotional things going on. Maybe it didn't come out right, but that's what I was saying.
In the midst of the turmoil he has endured over the course of his life, the Macho Man right now endures the heaviest. From Miss Elizabeth, we will show you that footage, that startling, that emotional interview from Miss Elizabeth that occurred on Monday Nitro later on in this telecast. Fans, stay right where you are. And what if she was sincere.
Yeah.
If she was sincere, her timing was wrong.
Yeah.
If she wasn't...
Her timing was wrong.
If everybody's timing was wrong.
There you
if
go.
She wasn't sincere,
yeah.
then it's just another NWO sick ploy.
You're right. And I'll tell you what, Silver Tongue Tony, the bottom line is, when this thing hit us, he was preparing to go to a match on this past Monday Night Raw. I'm talking about the Macho Man Randy Savage. We already said he went crazy. We seen him in a hotel room running up and down, and then all of a sudden he brought in front of a monitor and forced almost to watch this plea, if you will, from his former wife. That's dragging your laundry in the street. That's bringing it out for millions of people to see. Yes, he is upset, but I guarantee you one thing. The Macho Man Randy Savage got to deal with this, because the fighter's opponent is right around the corner, and there's a look of angry, angry violence in the eyes of the NWO.
Oh, Wade's lock takeover. One, two, and Alex Wright almost had his second straight win over Dean Malenko. There's a European uppercut, and Malenko is in trouble. He's wobbly. His feet are very, very wobbly on him, and whoa, that one caught him in the jaw. He almost went head first down that time. How about that drop kick?
Caught him with a good drop kick, going for a cover right here. A late look of the hook of the leg, if you will. But you were right. He was so close to beating him. Get another uppercut into a backslide.
Dean Malenko with the backslide. One, two. No, did not get him. Mark Curtis right on top of that call. There's a small package. One, two, and no.
Well, they both are pulling out all stops to get a victory right here. From a pounding on the back to a backsliding small package.
Wow, he tried a spin wheel kick and he kicked him in the knee. Drop kick, countered that move.
Wow. Boy, he got him hooked up here.
Got the arms hooked. One, two, three. Beats him.
Yeah.
The man of a thousand holds just showing us another one right there as he defeats Alex Wright, yanks off the mask. Boy, and he is your winner.
Yeah, and he yanked that thing off with the anticipation of going over and telling you all about it. I guess you one thing, Tony. Ask this young man some potent question about Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. And you see right here, both of them went up, one for a drop kick, one for a spin wheel kick, hooked both arms in a butterfly mode, rolls him over right here, got his shoulders there. Dean Malenko to the pay window, and also over to talk to the Silver Tongue Tony Schiavone. Standing by now, one, Dean Malenko.
Second straight time now for this man, Dean Malenko, avenging an earlier loss with a win, this time over Alex Wright. Based on what we've seen tonight, what we've seen recently on Nitro, I would think you're on a real hot streak going into your match next Sunday for the Cruiserweight Championship.
Tony, Rey Mysterio, listen up. If you were paying attention, last Monday night on Nitro, I stepped in the ring of Brad Armstrong and I defeated him. Brad, that's a lesson when you step in the ring of Dean Malenko more than once. Lightning will not strike twice. Now, you just witnessed Alex Wright going down in defeat. That's another example. Lightning doesn't strike twice. Ray, we're 1 week away from going toe-to-toe for the Cruiserweight title. Now, Ray, if I'm a betting man, I'm going to bet on a third time. Lightning will not strike twice. With you, Ray Mysterio.
That is going to be a tremendous match next Sunday for the Cruiserweight Championship. Back after this on Saturday night.
Here we go, fans, in the control center. I'm Tony Schiavone. We are now only 1 week away as Slim Jim presents WCW's Halloween Havoc live at the gorgeous MGM Grand and the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, Sunday, October 27th. That's next Sunday, starting time 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 on the West Coast. Make sure to call your local cable operator for availability. The mental state of the Macho Man, Randy Savage, in question as never before. I'm sure you heard the emotional plea from Miss Elizabeth this past Monday on Nitro, a statement so heavy that Savage left the arena, walked out, and did not return. The obvious questions, how will this affect him at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc? And was she really sincere, or is this just another ploy from that sick Hulk Hogan and the New World Order? Nevertheless, for Savage, this is the fight of his life. As the WCW World Heavyweight title will be on the line, Hogan defends against the Macho Man. Other title matches we'll see. The WCW World Tag Team title up for grabs. Harlem Heat defend against the Outsiders, Hall and Nash. For the WCW Cruiserweight title, Rey Mysterio Jr. meets Dean Malenko. And now Jeff Jarrett will take Nature Boy Ric Flair's place against the giant of the NWO. As you know, Flair injured by the New World Order just a week ago. We're going to have more later in this hour on this great card and a reminder to enter the Slim Jim Snap to Win sweepstakes. You could win a road legal Slim Jim monster truck or other great prizes. No purchase necessary, but time's running out, fans. All entries must be received by October 23rd, 1996. For more information, see in-store displays or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen. Be sure to see Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc by calling your local cable operator, calling DirecTV, or calling Turner Premier. It is now only 1 week from tomorrow night. Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc next Sunday, October 27th.
So it is going to be the battleground. It is going to be the most watched event ever because it's going to be the NWO with the WCW belt around its waist, namely Hulk Hogan, against the Macho Man Randy Savage if he can gather himself together. Speaking of NWO against WCW, there's a very stark contrast between the two organizations. One NWO upstart, very arrogant, nothing but a bunch of thugs, vandals. And then there's WCW, which represents the tradition of our sport that you know a lot about, Dream. And here's a young man, Jeff Jarrett, who really appreciates the tradition of the sport, realizes heritage, and stands firmly for WCW.
Well, so he says. And it's so true that Armstrongs, you can say the same about them and the Armstrong family. You made a couple good points right there. Jeff Jarrett locking up here with Armstrong right here. Go behind what wrestling ability he does have. But the good points that you had made. I don't recognize the NWO as another authoritative group as you do, as you most politely say. They are thugs. They have come in somehow and almost eliminated the tradition of WCW. Bottom line, I'm going to say it again. I said it at the start of the show. They cannot pull this off. Not only with DiBiase's money, they cannot pull this off without somebody higher up backing these guys. But we got to focus on the fight at hand. This young man right here, Jeff Jarrett, Tony.
Yes.
Got to focus on about 7'5", 500 pounds of the giant himself. He called for the match. I want the giant. I'm a giant killer, he said. I'm a giant killer. We're going to have an opportunity. Yes, heritage, he does. Tradition, Jeff Jarrett. What ability this young man has. Don't like his attitude sometimes, most of the time. But he's there. He's going to be there with the giant.
Power bombs down Steve Armstrong. Jeff Jarrett is the man, as you talked about, Dream, replacing the Nature Boy Ric Flair. We talked about how the NWO has attempted to destroy the tradition of WCW. They have injured Ric Flair. They have stolen the U.S. title belt. Jeff Jarrett's match against the Giant obviously will not be for the U.S. title. Ric Flair still has that, even though he's injured. However, we do understand that the 30-day clause is there. If Flair cannot bounce back from the injury that he received in 30 days, we're going to have to hold that title up and have some sort of, I don't know, tournament, round-robin event to name a new U.S. champion.
That's not for us to say. It's only for us to give the news. And you're right, you brought the news out. You see the walk of Jeff Jarrett. And you see the fasana about him. You know what I mean? What do you call it, fasana?
That's the road.
I mean, you see it all as we get ready for Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. Got to buy this thing on pay-per-view. Buy it, because it's going to be big. It's going to be a hitter. It's going to be fight. It's fight night in Las Vegas.
The MGM Grand, the Garden Arena, Ric Flair was supposed to join us last Monday on Nitro.
That's right.
And we understand he had to undergo an MRI in Charlotte, could not make it. We are not sure as of this time if his shoulder needs surgery or not.
Wow.
Here's a backslide, nicely done. Got a two count, and Steve Armstrong almost got a three, but Jeff Jarrett quickly back to the attack. A rake of the eyes, into the ropes, back elbow missed. Wow. Big lariat flying over the right side ropes.
Armstrong caught him real good. You talk about tradition. You're looking at it right here when you're talking about Armstrong and Jarrett. Got him in a power slam, didn't hook that leg up.
Then a splash, one, two, no.
He didn't need that extra splash it. If you weigh like 400 pounds, then you can extra splash it because then the weight is going to hit you. But when you're about, you know, 220 and in shape like he is, you don't need the extra splash it. Should have hooked him up right away. Gave him time to breathe. Got him up.
Drives the knee down on top of his knee.
Well, let's see if he hooks it in.
He's come in using that figure four leg lock, and let's see if he uses it now. This is tradition. This is heritage. This move.
Locked it up right there.
Locked it in. The figure four on Steve Armstrong. Randy Anderson is checking in. And this one very close to being over. Yes, it is. It is over. Calling the bell, Randy Anderson and Jeff Jarrett on his way now to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, live at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, awaits the Giant of the NWO.
Big win for Jeff Jarrett, looking real good. He owned the mothership on Saturday night. Me and the Silverton and Tony Schiavone. A lot of controversy even in our voices as we bounce this thing back and forth the way we feel and what we see as we go into this event. It has become a mega, mega event when we are talking about Las Vegas, Nevada, MGM Grand Garden, if you will. I guarantee you one thing, this man better be ready for the Giant. You see him slingshot right off that top rope, hooked him in, and then hooks in a figure four. Hooks it in good. Right here, Jeff Jarrett on the way to the pay window on Saturday night. Tony Schiavone making your way over there. Jeff Jarrett. Hey, Tony, I guarantee you one thing. Jeff is tradition. Ask him about it.
Another tremendous win for Jeff Jarrett. Jeff, come on in here undefeated. Oh, yeah, since coming into World Championship Wrestling, we made the announcement this past Monday. You and the Giant next Sunday at Halloween Havoc. And I know you realize what a tall order you have, not only because of the Giant, but because of the entire NWO.
That's exactly right, Tony Schiavone. 8 days and counting for Jeff Jarrett. I said I was coming to Nitro to make an impact, and I've done that. I said I was coming to WCW Saturday night to make an impact, and I did that. Now, Giant, I'm telling you, I'm going to Halloween Havoc to make the biggest impact of them all. Because like I said, it's not if, Tony, it's when I chop you down to size, Giant, and put that figure four right on your big stinking legs. You and the rest of the NWO will respect Jeff Jarrett. And as far as the NWO goes, Hall and Nash and Hogan and the Giant, the rest of the crew, you're supposed to be real big, bad, and impressive. Hogan, you're supposed to be hotter than ever. Well, you don't impress me one bit, because as far as it goes with Jeff Jarrett, the NWO stands for Non-Wrestling Organization. So at Halloween Havoc, it ain't gonna happen on the strip. It ain't gonna happen outside the ring. It's gonna happen inside the ring, Giant. And you've chokeslammed them all. To Savage, Flair, Arn Anderson, all the way down the line. But you hadn't chokeslammed me. And after Halloween Havoc, you still want to chokeslam Jeff Jarrett. See you in Havoc.
Sure will, Jeff. And we'll be back with more on TBS after this. Today on the WCW Hotline, insider Mike Tenay has a scoop on pro wrestling's hottest free agent. This former world champ and one of the best wrestlers in the sport is rumored to be leaving his current organization. Where is he going, and how does this involve WCW? The only way you can find out is by calling Mike Tenay on the hotline today until midnight. 1-900-909-9900. $1.49 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission before you call. And now let's go back to Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream.
I tell you what, welcome back to Saturday Night. You know what, Tony? This thing is heating up. Mike Enos, Bunkhouse Buckface Affair, getting ready to come on here and get it on the mothership. Man, we have put controversy back in the lap of the NWO so far on this Saturday night.
No question about it, and there is a look at Bunkhouse Buck and Mike Enos together. How about that? One half of Rough and Ready and Bunkhouse Buck, Colonel Parker's men are out here, but we don't see Dick Slater anywhere.
I was going to say, where's Dick Slater? I mean, the past few months, he's been in there, and they just have been forming a great team, and Bunkhouse Buck has been gone, and now he comes back in with that curly hair sticking right in the middle there, that Tennessee curl, he calls it, in there with Mike Enos. This is a real mean path, but are they going against some power?
No question about it.
Say that twice.
Did I say no question about it?
No, I mean two times, like back to back. This is like you're playing tennis.
Okay.
At home, the people watching TV, they're going like this. All right. Well, no question about these guys.
Well, there you go. You want to volley all night or what here?
No. They got the power and the snake of the grass with them.
I was just on him.
You were just doing what?
This looks like a Taskmaster.
This one is for the Taskmaster, says Jimmy Hart, and here they are. members of the Dungeon of Doom, the members of the Faces of Fear. Has anyone seen Colonel Parker yet?
No, and I'm going to tell you what. Yeah, if you speak coming up the aisle, if you would look from your position, I know you have a pole in front of you.
There he is.
You know, you think in Tiger Stadium. Yeah, look around it. Well, they got you sitting, and you can see me with a big cigar.
Colonel Parker out to say something to Buck. Oh, he raised his cane towards Mike Enos.
Well, maybe this is over the Slater thing. I don't understand this, but you know Colonel Parker's been spending more time with Harlem Heat than he has. Hey, what's going on here? He's got that quick walk about him, don't he?
He really does.
When he starts moving, he's got that walk where it looks almost like fast motion. Oh, look. Oh, my goodness. I'm telling you, you see Nick Patrick.
Yeah, he's a hurting.
I mean, he's hurting bad.
Yeah, he really is. Well, Colonel Parker, the manager of Bunkhouse Buck, certainly he's had his differences with the members of Rough and Ready, but here they are together. And here we go, Faces of Fear. Look at me, if you will.
Come on, somebody throw me a tubeful. Brother, was he in a mess? He was in a mess from the get-go there. Oh, man.
That was literally fist of fire.
Yeah, Daddy, I'd like you to meet one of the Faces of Fear. Bam, bam, bam.
That'll knock that lard right off his hair, won't it?
Look at that lard in here. Anyway.
Well, I was referring to that goop he has on his head to keep his hair down. Yeah, back elbow. How about it? That stunned him and then a foot to the gut. And a choke. That boy, that didn't work at all.
No, it didn't. And a big power slam right here. And Mean is just as big and as bad as he wants to be and Face the Fear. I said this on numerous occasions. These guys right here are really in a position, if they just don't want to hurt you, but where they are really knowledgeable enough to carry a world's heavyweight title. Tag team wise it is. Let me ask you this other question. Let me throw this in there on top of all this other controversy.
All right.
Taskmaster and the Dungeon of Doom have really come out of this thing almost unscathed with the NWO.
You're right.
I believe that they are preparing themselves a little bit better. Like him or not, leadership is what drives great teams to be great teams. They have a leader, WCW. We don't have a leader right now, as my colleague, Larry the Legend Zbyszko, so astutely says about 9,000 times, we ain't got no leader, and we need one, right or wrong.
Well, we need it. The leader of WCW throughout the years has been Sting, but ever since the 16th of September when he made his statement on Nitro and he walked out, we've not seen him.
We are.
Sting, what is he all about? And what if Sting shows up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc? Will he be on the side of WCW, on the side of the NWO, or to the highest bidder? That's a question maybe we'll have answered at the MGM Grand next Sunday. Mike Enos, though, he's fighting with a purpose here. Look at this.
Yeah, well, he turned around. He's going to hurt him by hitting him in the head. I guarantee you that.
Wow, big sledgehammer blow.
Yeah, and boy, he hooked him up right here. And Nick Patrick here just pointing. I mean, you know, I'm talking about a pitiful sight. I want to say that in public. Nick Patrick is pitiful. He is a pitiful man. He's turned into a pitiful referee. He should not be in this Saturday Night Mothership program. That's my opinion. And if you ever talk to him again, tell him that.
One, two, Bunkhouse Buck makes a save. I basically said that.
I know you did. I'm proud of you.
That if
this
you're
past
injured,
Monday, yeah, if you're injured,
get
stay out.
Out. There,
yeah,
right.
But Tony, he ain't injured.
Well, he's not injured on Sunday night.
No.
It seems that last Sunday night on the pro, he told us before the matches began that, hey, I'm okay.
It hindered him, he said.
Yeah.
Yeah, the neck brace hindered him.
It hindered him, so we'll go without it. But here
I
he is back again.
We spend too much time on him. That's what I believe.
Thank you, right. Midsection, backhand chop in this Face to Fear team. By the way, they'll be going to WCW Monday Nitro. Monday Nitro is live coming your way from Mankato, Minnesota this Monday. And up in Minnesota, the Faces of Fear will meet the Rock and Roll Express in a big tag team battle. That should be tremendous. Speed against power there. And here comes Bunkhouse Buck back in. He blocked that right hand. Buck with those big cowboy boots. Look at this.
Well, he only knows one way is to break him down. But they are finding it very hard because of the rock-solid thickness of the Face of Fear. Got him hooked up.
Sunset Flip got him down. He only got a one count out of that. Nick very slow. Uh-oh.
Yeah, here they come. Here they come.
Colonel Parker brings out Sherry. Can we listen in here or not? I didn't know the poor listening in here. Good love, birds squawking away. Here's a one count only. A save that time by Enos. Oh, there goes Ming again. Look at this. Ming just pounding away on Mike Enos. And Enos trying to fight back.
There ain't no fighting back to that.
He's over the top is Mike Enos.
That gets you in a situation where you can't.
A foot to the face of Ming, and then a foot to Bunkhouse Buck.
And then a foot to Enos, and then a cowboy hat behind the head.
And a 1-2-3 in the ring, Barbarian.
They got the win. Uh-oh.
He wants to hit. I don't know if it's Sherry, watch out, or Colonel Parker here, but we got to step out, fans, because we have standing by on the telephone Lee Marshall with our 1-800-COLLECT-ROAD-REPORT. Lee, all across America, reporting in on great events. Lee, where are you tonight?
Hi, Tony. I'm in La Crosse, Wisconsin, spending this beautiful autumn evening with our WCW fans at the La Crosse Civic Center. Now, some of the greatest wrestling stars in the world have already arrived here. And just a few minutes from now, we're going to be inside to see some great WCW action live. Now, for you fans in the La Crosse area, there's still a lot of time to join us. We've got tickets at all the usual locations or right here at the door of the La Crosse Civic Center. Tony, Dusty, I got to run. I got to go inside. That is our 1-800-COLLECT-ROAD-REPORT. I'm Lee Marshall.
The gorgeous MGM Grand in the Garden Arena, the setting on the Strip in Las Vegas for pro wrestling's biggest night. It is next Sunday. Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, exclusively on pay-per-view. Next Sunday, October 27th, originating from the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Can't wait to get to the MGM Grand, the Garden Arena. It's going to be an electric weekend, and it's going to be next weekend, as a matter of fact. WCW will be there in full force, and of course, next Sunday night, 27th of October, WCW presents its annual event, Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc.
And one thing is for sure, when you talk pay-per-views, buying pay-per-views, this one really has the intrigue of all intrigues. Tony, I'll tell you something else here about Lex Luger and Arn Anderson. I really did not think he would be here tonight with the way he's back here. I'm talking about one Lex Luger,
right,
the total package. I'm telling you, he was a hurt this past Monday night. I mean, a hurt.
Seems to be that the...
But a week's went by.
That's right. It's,
you know,
not as much bandage around that back right now, so maybe it's feeling a lot better and we're not so sure. Here we are, Lex Luger, the total package, and Arn Anderson to go one-on-one. It's a match at Halloween Havoc, sponsored by Slim Jim's, that's brought on about what happened at Fall Brawl. But for Lex Luger right now, the youngster Mark Starr here on Saturday night.
Well, the young Mark Starr knows one thing, to make his name and really put it down in the record books right here on Saturday night. He's got to do it on the mothership, and I guarantee you one thing is for certain, he will be at the top of his game. We better be at the top of our game. What I mean by we is the fans of WCW where the big boys play. And then on the other hand, you say, well, there's NWO fans. Obviously, we see all that merchandising out there. So the fans of NWO, they're saying, well, we better be on top of our game. All I know that the fighter going on is the Macho Man Randy Savage, who is emotionally distraught after what has happened to him when his laundry has been drug out in the street, thrown to millions of people, and say, this is what it's going to be like if you ever leave your wife. I mean, it makes it for bad surroundings. Yes.
Do you think that he is upset because, as you say, his laundry was thrown out in the street, or he's upset because he still has feelings for the lady and he thought that she was sincere?
I guarantee you, I knew him when he was with her, and he loved this woman, if I may use that word, if it's politically
watch
correct.
Watch out, roll up, 1-2 count that time.
I mean, he cared so much and dearly for her, and I thought her dearly for him. She looked sincere, right around.
Yeah.
I mean, she looked sincere. It was a wrong time for him to see this right prior to his match. But she looked sincere. If this is a plot by the NWO, this is the most devious one of them all. It would drive you to being crazy and even drive you to drinking. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, my goodness. Make a man crazy. A rake to the eyes, and Lex Luger finds Mark Starr ready and able in this matchup.
That's what I said at the start of it. When I gave my scout report on it, the rundown, I said he's going to be at the top of his game. It has to be
to beat the total package Lex Luger.
Luger drops to his knees to get the leverage advantage, gets a 1-2 count, and almost gets a win with a backslide here on Saturday night.
And it was gingerly done, too. I still don't believe he can bend all the way over the way he should.
Injuring the back.
And this is no good.
Yeah, you're not kidding. On the outside, does not work at all for Lex Luger. Arn Anderson, when he took the chair to the back last week, certainly knew that if he would injure the back of Lex Luger, he would take away the torture rack. And Mark Starr better watch himself, pushing referees around.
Well, Arn Anderson is a big man with a lot of power, and he's going to put Arn in the torture rack. He's going to have all his faculties about him, and that means a good front. Well, see, Mark Starr should have did that from the get-go. Go ahead and go to work on that thing. Get it in a better, worse-off situation than it was already in.
The back, the rib cage, the lower ribs injured by Arn Anderson a week ago, and of course now a week away, Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. What if Luger cannot pick him up in the torture rack? What would he resort to next? What would be his next move? His next way to win a match? Well, we've seen Luger win with more than just torture rack.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What are you talking about?
He would have to maybe like a figure four where he wouldn't have to use the back.
You use your back in anything you do.
Wouldn't have to use the back as much.
I mean,
are you
cooking.
Satisfied now?
I mean,
there's a power slam.
I've seen you in the kitchen cooking.
Yeah, well,
and you're using
to.
Your back. That's what I mean. Okay. Boy, she better not hear you talk like that.
Okay, and he's going to go with a torture rack. Bad back.
Got him up.
And he got him up. He got him up.
That's what he needed to do right there. Need to get rid of him, though. Held him too long. Look pretty stable. The total package next, Luger.
He picked him up with ease that time, Green.
Yeah, he did. And well, he got him in a situation too, where you know, Starr don't weigh as much as Arn Anderson. And I think another week maybe with this back, if you don't get in no friction with anybody on this back, will help him out. You're gonna see it right here. Goes Mark Starr in. Mark Starr was trying to play the game of his life. Got him right here in a slam. That had to hurt your back just a little bit. Then he goes ahead and racks him up right here in front of all of us, right here on Saturday night here on TBS. Now the Silver Tongue Tony Schiavone going to ask him not only an important question, but Tony walking away, turn around here. Tony, ask him how his back is for me, Dusty Rhodes. I need to know really, not watching him, but how's his back? Take it, Tony.
We'll ask him just that question. Let's bring in Lex Luger right now. You seem to be looking good. How's the back feeling now, 1 week away from Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc?
You know, Tony, maybe we should ask Mark Starr that. Or better yet, maybe we should have Arn Anderson ask Mark Starr, because my back's feeling good. It's feeling really good. And come Halloween Havoc, I'm going to be 100% and being the total package like only the total passage can be. Now, Anderson, life's about timing. And you've got real bad timing. And you know why? When the WCW should be banding together, you're trying to divide and conquer. We've all got our problems. My relationship with Sting is disintegrated. You know what? When you kick a man, or I said say, take a chair to a man when he's down, sometimes that backfires, and it's backfiring on you. Your game plan's crumbling, and Halloween Havoc is real close. It's rolling around. And Arn Anderson, I said it many, many times, but now I'm saying it with more belief in my heart than ever before. I'm going to beat you in Halloween Havoc. I'm going to wreck you. And the total package is gonna hurt you.
The total package is ready. The back is all right. And we are back on Saturday night after this. I tell you, Dusty, as we head to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, if this was a plot by the NWO, this whole thing was concocted by Hulk Hogan, it may have worked for him.
Well, I tell you what, if roadblocks are set up, we're talking about tonight the Macho Man Randy Savage into meeting a man named Roadblock. Well, this might be the ultimate roadblock, if you know what I'm talking about. And I've seen the Nasty Boys fall prey to selfishness.
Let's take you to Nitro this past Monday.
To chop you down to size when I slap that figure four leg like on you. You and the rest of the stinking NWO. That's right. You're going to respect Ric Flair. You're you're going to respect WCW and the wrestling heritage that goes way back. And last but not least, oh, and you too, Hogan, all the NWO is going to respect Jeff Jarrett.
Somebody get some security out here. Kyle and Nash, they want to do it.
Let's do
Look
it.
Look at this.
I know that this is awkward for both of us, but I've done everything I can to try to get your attention and to try to explain to you how I feel, and you won't listen. And one of the worst choices I've made is signing with Hulk, knowing how self-serving he is, and then using me to hurt you. I'm really lost, and I need you, and I don't think I can reach you. Really alone. And I know that I feel the same way about you today as I did the day I said I do.
All she just wanted to talk to you, Randy. She wanted you to know how she felt. Look at this. They are literally holding her hostage. The entire NWO.
I can push any button I want to on the Macho Man. I can push the button to make him run. I can push the button and make him hide. And now, after the greatest actress in the world, the lovely Elizabeth. See how good she is. Hey, man, you too can join the party. It's NWO time. You know what, man? You two brothers. You guys have never done me wrong. You watched my back the last couple weeks.
Oh, they've got their contracts.
When NWO was taking care of business. I love you guys more than I love my old family, man. And I just want to let you know, if there's anything I can do for you, if there's anything that ever needs to be done, just call on me because I'll be there, brother.
I know this must sound stupid. I don't even want to bother you with it. But, you know, the lack of communication around here. On the contract that Ted gave us, you know, on the limousine and the clear jets, and most of all, the money with the decimal point where it should be a little further back, and we should be getting the money, you know, what I'm talking about. I don't know if it's just a screw up. I know, Kelly, Blue, you know, you have know nothing about it, but, you know.
No, brother, that should all be in there. Turn the page. Where's my signature? No, the Learjets, the limousines, the money on the paper, that should all, whoa. I mean, I didn't sign that. Do you see my signature on that? You know something, brother? I didn't sign this. So this is the contract I laid out, but you know, you shouldn't have these shirts on unless I sign this. You know what I'm saying?
Well, what the hell are you talking about?
What I'm talking about is you don't wear our colors unless we tell you.
Unbelievable.
Take care of the family business, honey. How do you like that, Liz?
Be sure to join us this coming Monday. 2 hours of WCW Monday Nitro Live, only on TNT, originating from Mankato, Minnesota. You'll see Harlem Heat in a non-title match take on the American Males. The Rock and Roll Express will meet the Faces of Fear. Jeff Jarrett one-on-one against Ron Studd. Bobby Eaton takes on Chris Jericho, plus Lex Luger, the Macho Man Randy Savage, Diamond Dallas, and many others. 8 o'clock Eastern Time, 2 hours of WCW Monday Nitro. It comes your way live this Monday. WCW Monday Nitro comes your way from the great state of Minnesota, Mankato, Minnesota, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, 2 hours live this Monday on TNT. Earlier on, we saw Jeff Jarrett in competition, who has the Giant coming up next Sunday at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. And here comes Big Ron Studd.
And we have these comments pre-recorded earlier on today from Big Ron Studd about Monday Nitro this coming Monday.
Jeff Jarrett, you don't know if you're a country singer or a wrestler, but I know one thing. I'm 7'2", psycho, 425-pound wild man. This Monday night, you're going to be singing the blues.
Hey, Ron Studd is going to be a great test for Jeff Jarrett as it pertains to leading into Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. But he cannot look past, in Ron Studd, this man right here, Chavo Guerrero Jr.
No, he came in with the heritage and tradition, as we talk about here at WCW, where the big boys play, and really got some much-needed victories and really pumped himself up here at WCW. Ron Studd is big. I mean, they're big guys, and then they are bigger than bigger guys. And this guy, if you don't have a television or listen on radio, is big as you were. If you were walking through your door and you looked up at the top of the wall, that's how big he is. And Jeff Jarrett claiming to be a giant killer. Guerrero might be a giant killer right here.
Still to come in this telecast, the Macho Man Randy Savage will be here later on in our main event. And
look at the size here.
Oh, size differential is incredible. And
he would need a step ladder to get up there and do this handsy thing with him.
The handsy thing?
Handsy thing. Is get up and they get up there and you put your hands and see about the most strength. And the one with the least strength usually be down on the bottom. Now he's down at a regular 6'4" size.
Chavo down over the top and drop.
Now he got him down.
The
That's where he got to keep him down. He need to drop kick him in the knee or something and keep him down. Keep him running like a crazy dog.
He can't get him down. As a matter of fact, Chavo Jr. hitting the mat more than Ron Studd is. Trying to moonsault. He got him over. And he's going to cover him 1-2. And the big guy lumbers out of
that. This
will
be a big win in more ways than one. You know what I mean? Wow.
Ducks the clothesline as Chavo Jr. And boy, that's ill advised.
Yeah, he ran into a bad situation.
Wow.
A backbreaker from way up. I'm talking about picking him up again high above the tent. High above the big top.
Ron Studd plants him down, and big Ron Studd. Just not hit yourself in the head.
Yeah, it's like he's trying to get a wake-up call right here, but he didn't cover him, and that might come back to haunt him.
You're not kidding.
He did not cover him, Tony.
Here's a pickup, and
wow, that's way up there.
That is way up there.
It's like flying one in there.
Beats him with your basic vertical suplex.
Yeah, but not basic. Long, tall, big vertical suplex. Ron Studd on his way to Monday Night Nitro with Jeff Jarrett, the Giant Killer.
Still to come, the Macho Man Randy Savage plus Chris Benoit and more on WCW Saturday Night.
WCW, what the big boys wear.
Ooh, yeah, get your WCW Slim Jim Halloween Havoc shirt hot off the press.
Get your very own Halloween Havoc t-shirt for just $19.95 plus $5.95 shipping and handling.
Ooh, yeah, get your Slim Jim Halloween Havoc shirt and get it macho size, yeah. So that you can be one of the people being cool.
Just call 1-800-WCW-8661.
Ooh, yeah, dig it.
Hey, Mom.
This is NWO Saturday Night. It's round one of the NWO Invitational Cruiserweight Title Tournament. World-renowned Johnny T-Tough Acapella will bring out the Screaming Sleeper against Six. Now to your host, the Outsiders.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the NWO Arena for the first round of the NWO Cruiserweight Tournament. Our first opponent from the dark side, weighing 198 pounds, international sensation, Johnny Two-Tough Acapella. And his opponent, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, at 222 pounds, a member of the New World Order, and my personal favorite wrestler, welcome, Six.
Standing cruiserweight double knockout.
All right, bring that bell. The referee for this match is the none other than the Masked Assassin,
currently known as Dr. X. Fill out process. Here's Six.
Six. Yes. With a cruiserweight weight limit. Since that time, also.
Big headlock there.
Headlock.
He's working it.
Oh, spinning into the hammerlock. Nice move by Six.
Come on, man. What do you say? Now this NWO. NWO seems to have
Acapella.
I believe it is. His name is the Incredible Acapella. This guy, the thing is, the NWO has covered all their bases there, Scott. They've got a tag situation. They've got the world situation. Now a cruiserweight.
Like we said earlier, NWO coming in to take over. And like we said before, WCW. It's not that building in Atlanta. It's not the ring truck. It's not the television trucks. It's the wrestlers. It's the individual talent. And that's where the NWO is going after each talent. After
like
each
six
title.
Six a little shook up. Let's go back to action. Colin Elbow. Six uses his girth and weight advantage to push him back to the corner.
Look for a clean break.
Oh, my goodness. He's taking shortcuts early.
Hey, that's cheating.
Like we've said. Oh, into the turnbuckle. Six looks to be in a little bit of trouble. Oh. This man is a madman.
Come on,
known in the Latin America circles as a strictly brawler. Oh.
Taking advantage. Six looks to be in a deep trouble here. And back to a headlock, Sino. He's showing his experience here, going back to the hold.
Oh, high impact. That's going to leave a mark.
Belly to back souffle.
Well, that affects all seven cervicals, a couple of lumbars.
And all 14 movable vertebrae.
Oh, jeez.
Ooh, that
car
had
wreck.
To hurt. That had to hurt. Oh, and Six taking it to the outside.
This kid's showing a different side we haven't seen.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah! Oh!
Hey. A little out of control here. Let's get it back up on this train. Six showing that violent streak that he's noted for.
Unbelievable. Showing something we haven't seen out of this man in the past. That aggressive side.
Crazy.
Oh, knife edge.
First knife edge.
Another one. Seemingly tearing the skin away. Like peeling an onion.
Oh.
Hey,
that
you
know
where you're at?
Hurt.
You know where you're at?
I know from personal
Shades
experience.
Of David Carradine.
Yeah,
you know, Scott, Six seems to really be good. Snap there.
Nicely done.
Got all of that one. Got all of that one.
That leg drop, John, nobody does it better.
Joining us in the announce booth.
Who says that?
Legendary son.
Who says that? He does.
A little aggressive there.
Six back in control.
Looks like he's setting up here for a souffle.
Vertical souffle.
Goodness.
Nicely done.
High verticals.
Oh, that could come back to haunt him.
Aha, fine maneuver.
That could come back to haunt him.
I'm having fun. How are you having fun? Beat him up.
I dare you to spin kick him.
You can hear the fans.
Oh, rolling their approval. I dare you to spin kick him.
He's coming our way.
Oh, explodes into the...
Oh, jeez. Did you see the impact?
That's a buzz killer.
I'm right here, and I tell you, this guy is taking a punishment. This youngster is on Queer Street.
And loving it.
Spinning kick!
That had to hurt. Oh!
Hit the frog!
A victory for Six. Here's your winner, ladies and gentlemen, from the New World Order. It is Six!
Man. Robinson out of the Cruiserweight Tournament. Six.
An impressive victory by six. Let's try to get a word with this young man. Six, I know you're a little out of breath. An impressive win. You got to hand it to Acapella here. He was tough enough to come into the Wolfpack, into the Lion's Den, face you in the first round of the NWO Cruiserweight Tournament. Congratulations, nicely done. Anything to say to your millions of fans out
there? Yeah, dude, get that camera on me. Jerry Capello was a tough customer, but I'm a swinging man. And you don't come in to the Wolf Den and jump on the swinger without getting hurt.
Acapella, Acapella, whatever, 220, 221.
Whatever it takes. You know, when it's NWO, I'm digging it the most.
Hey, it stunk over there. I mean,
we love to say we told you so, and we told you so. Zoom.
We are back, fans, in the control center as Slim Jim presents WCW's Halloween Havoc live at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, now only 1 week away. It's next Sunday, October 27th. Starting time 8 p.m. Eastern and 5 on the West Coast. Call your local cable operator right now for availability. Don't be left out. Now here's the rundown for Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc as we have it. The WCW World title on the line, the champ Hollywood Hulk Hogan of the NWO meets the Macho Man Randy Savage of WCW. The WCW World Tag Team Championship on the line, Harlem Heat to defend against the Outsiders, Hall and Nash of the New World Order. For the WCW Cruiserweight title, Rey Mysterio Jr. meets Dean Malenko. Ric Flair is out, he's injured, he won't be competing. He'll not be able to meet the Giants, therefore taking his spot, Jeff Jarrett. He'll meet the Giant and hopefully try to steal that title back from the Giant that the NWO heisted a week ago. Also in tag action, the Faces of Fear against Chris Benoit and Steve Mongo McMichael of the Four Horsemen. In a match for the Battle Bowl ring, Diamond Dallas Page goes one-on-one against Eddie Guerrero. Lex Luger will face Arn Anderson of the Four Horsemen, and Chris Jericho meets six of the NWO. Here's a reminder to be sure to enter the Slim Jim Snap to Win Sweepstakes, where you can win a Road Legal Slim Jim Monster Truck or other great prizes. No purchase necessary, but time is running out, fans. All entries must be received by this Tuesday, October 23rd, 1996. For more information, see in-store displays or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen. Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc is 1 week from tomorrow night. The pay-per-view spectacular can be seen by calling your local cable operator, DirecTV at 1-800-347-3288 or Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266. 1 week from tomorrow night, Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. Next Sunday at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, the Dungeon of Doom will meet the Horsemen in tremendous tag team action. Here's a special look at one of the biggest rivalries in the history of WCW.
Going to be a tremendous tag team event as the Dungeon of Doom, namely the Faces of Fear, meet Chris Benoit, Steve Mongo, McMichael of the Horsemen. It will be Dungeon of Doom Horsemen colliding, part of Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. All right, Kenny Long brings in the Pit Bull, one of the finest former amateurs ever to put on the tights in the pro ranks. That'll be Craig Pit Bull Pittman here on Saturday night.
There have been times where Craig the Pit Bull Pittman looks like he was really going to break away from the pack and be something special. A special human being he is, and he's with a special man. We're talking about Teddy Long, the master motivator, if you will. Good friend of WCW, talk about tradition. But Craig Pittman needs to do something big, and he needs to do it right now. And something big to me would be to beat Chris Benoit right here on Saturday night.
Chris Benoit, the Crippler, making his way out here. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to remind you the Macho Man still to come. Chris Jericho, the Lionheart, is here as well. And you know, we had a chance to see the Macho Man earlier. He was very, very upset, wasn't he? He was off in another world, so to speak.
Well, you would be. That's what all I'm saying is that is so understandably, so as you so aptly put it, that is so true. Athletes going through this thing is more than just going to the fight at pay-per-view. It's more than just doing that. I mean, he's got to get mentally right, and I don't know if he can.
And we'll have this match in its entirety after this timeout on Saturday night.
Action statement. NWO's back in black.
White and ice, quite lovely.
Survivor shirt!
What do you say? Extra large? Double X?
Giant size.
The NWO t-shirt for just $20 plus $5.95 shipping and handling. Call 1-800-NWO-0242.
Plus, it makes you look skinny on TV!
Buy this shirt!
The preceding announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
We are back on WCW Saturday Night. Tony Schiavone and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And we've been talking about the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and how he feels. And wait a minute, there's a pickup and face first. How about that? Sending Chris Benoit down.
Well, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, don't feel real well. We got roadblock today. That roadblock put here, maybe the roadblock's already been thrown up. And I'm talking about this past Nitro after going through everything he did. And as this roadblock really coming from the NWO, where is it coming from? Where's this roadblock? Don't throw your hands up at me.
I don't know. I mean, we saw him about 500 pounds, and you're right.
No, I'm talking about past Monday Nitro.
The
roadblock already been thrown up.
Yeah.
If she is not sincere, everybody in America was crying. Everybody had big tears rolling out their eyes.
That was a very, very heavy
interview.
Yeah, if
she's not sincere, I guarantee you. Whoa! It was the schemes of the NWO once again. And it's going to come back to haunt us here at WCW with a big boy's play.
Well, the Macho Man, as we saw in the footage, and that was not the end of what happened that night.
No,
as you saw, the Nasty Boys, I thought they were a part of the NWO.
You mean business. You see that walk?
Yeah, you're not kidding. And I think it's been very apparent from all of us by Hulk Hogan's mannerisms and actions that he was just leaving the Nasty Boys on anyway. As a matter of fact, the Nasty Boys will be here coming up tomorrow night on WCW's Pro here
at
on
505 TBS. Eastern Time.
That's right.
And let me tell you something about the Nasty Boys. They love a party, and they love a fight, and they love limousines and all this. And they ran off on this thing. I know these kids. They ran off half-cocked. Say, we're going to have a party, and ran up here, and they got shot, brother. And look at this now. Look at this confrontation between Teddy Long and Nick Patrick. Bottom line, you can't wear our colors unless I've signed this thing. That's what I'm saying about the NWO, is they have this whole situation under control as far as they're concerned. These guys here got to retaliate. I'm talking about WCW.
And Chris Benoit,
Nick Patrick is pitiful.
Yeah, Chris Benoit would be the first man in line. You're not going to find a tougher man in our sport than the Wolverine Chris Benoit. And Steve,
we're both these guys.
Yes, they're both tough. I know that. He and Steve Mongo McMichael. What a team they are. And they will collide with the Faces of Fear next Sunday. Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc in a collision of two of the biggest and baddest tag teams in our sport. The chant of USA getting this Marine to bounce back up here. He's on all fours. And look, he absorbed that one.
Yeah, Benoit's really taking it to him, too. And caught him off guard to change momentum, put it over in his court. I'm talking about Benoit. We got Nick Patrick in there hurting from the neck. Teddy Long's on the outside. in the big marina. The firing back now. Cut him off.
Snapmare takeover. The pit bull, Craig Pittman, goes down. And here comes Benoit once again on the attack. Benoit, everything he does, so ooh, sharp. And there it is again.
Yeah, quick. That's right. Quick fist is the word you use.
Yes, it is.
And it's good.
Intense is another one.
Yeah.
Within the camp of the horsemen, they call him the Wolverine. Here's the cover. One, two. Got a lateral press and a two count.
They call who the Wolverine?
Benoit. In fact, I have seen fans here with signs. There was one fan that says, "Come back, Sting, I believe you."
Yes.
And there's another fan that said Teddy Long should be senior referee in WCW.
Yeah, I seen both of them.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and both of them pretty potent.
Pretty what?
Pretty potent. Pretty potent statement. Let me finish. They important potent statement. And that's true. Yes. Where is Sting? Will we see him at this pay-per-view at WCW Slim Jim Halloween Havoc coming from Las Vegas, Nevada? I don't know. I hope so. Get loose from it, Sting. Come on, baby.
Scoop slam and a good one by Benoit. Benoit with the ability, and the same thing applies to the pit bull, to take a lot of punishment but still fight like it was the opening bell.
Yeah, that's true. And both of them know the importance of getting a win here on the mothership here on TBS on a Saturday night, WCW Saturday night. And they are pounding on each other right now. I mean, they are really ragtagging it.
Back and forth they go. This is toe-to-toe in the corner, and neither man will give an inch here.
Ooh.
Well, that fired him up, and that put him down, that headbutt. How about that from the pit bull, Craig Pittman?
Let's see if he can put him away, though. That's the important thing about it right now. You got him in a situation now where you need to put him away. Don't make a mistake, and you just did.
Oh, and Nick Patrick
what?
Apparently was in the line of fire that time because he is hurting.
What happened to him?
You know, the Macho Man choked him about a month ago.
Longer than that, almost. I know it. Don't tell me.
Right out loud. And
don't
meanwhile,
tell me.
Chris Benoit continues this punishment.
Going up high for a high-risk maneuver here. I talk about this so often. You miss this, could cost you a match. He got him, though. Hooked it in.
One, two, three. He makes a three count on that one. Your winner, the crippler Chris Benoit.
Are we going to see this again? I want to see if we see what happened with Nick Patrick. You know, because I guarantee you one thing. Craig Pitbull Pittman is down for a long time here. Something else is rotten here. I guarantee you that.
Right, I'm going to go over to interview you. Take it away.
Who are you interviewing?
Arn
Nick
Anderson.
Patrick, are you interviewing?
Who? Arn Anderson and woman. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, you need to ask about Elizabeth. I guarantee that much. Going up high right here off the top. Chris Benoit, one of the four horsemen, hooks him up. Chris Benoit on the way to the pay window. I want to split that money with a horseman. Anyway. Ask Iron about Liz. Tony Schiavone standing by with Iron Anderson.
All right, we are now 1 week away from Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. The big revelation last week. I'm standing here, of course, with Arn Anderson and woman that the horsemen are through with Miss Elizabeth.
Yes, we are, Tony. And we're finished with her. We're absolutely done, AA. We don't have to worry about her anymore. But one thing we do have to worry about is really what's under our skin, and that's Lex Luger. And AA, you can always count on me. I'm with the horsemen, and you know that.
You know, woman, one thing we can't stand is a quitter. Am I right about that?
Absolutely right.
Lex Luger, you're a coward, and you're a quitter. And you wonder why you're starting to feel isolated these days while Sting won't have anything to do with you. You feel like I'm stalking you. You let WCW down. You let myself down and you let Ric Flair down. You quit. Well, what you did was show that you got no guts living underneath that fabulous body of yours. At Halloween Havoc, the sands of the hourglass are trickling down on you, Luger. Because you gotta see, when you meet a horseman, head up, you find out what has made us so great for the last 10 years. When we meet adversity face to face, that's when we're at our best. Now I know everybody's looking and saying, Arn Anderson's the underdog, Luger's got all these physical skills. But the thing what you don't have going for you, Luger, rests right here. It's called guts. And I get you down at Halloween Havoc, and I get you in that precarious situation, all those muscles aren't going to help you. I want to hear those words come out of your mouth with a lot of bass. I quit.
Arn Anderson and Lex Luger at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. It is next Sunday, and we'll have more Saturday night. after this timeout.
There's only one place to be in the entertainment capital of the world, and that's the MGM Grand. Join us at the Garden Arena for Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, 1 week from tomorrow night. Next Sunday, October 27th, available only on pay-per-view, coming your way at 8 o'clock Eastern Time.
All right, Chris Jericho at our next matchup here on WCW Saturday night. Still to come, the Macho Man Randy Savage. We're going to show you a little bit of what has gone on in his life over the past couple of months as it pertains not only to Miss Elizabeth, but to Hulk Hogan and Chris Jericho. They call him Lionheart, and he's making his way to the ring here on WCW Saturday night against Mark Bagwell. But for this young man, Chris Jericho, who's been such a sensation in our sport, he's another one of the WCW members that has to go up against the NWO at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc against Six.
Yeah, and Six needs to be taken out the back. I'm telling you, this guy right here, Chris Jericho, up and coming, if not already that big star here at WCW with a big bars plate. NWO. No, we're coming now. Fights are on in Las Vegas, only on pay-per-view. And you see this here, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, Scotty Riggs, trying to kill mosquitoes right here in the arena.
I thought they were trying to land a plane.
I'm telling you, yeah.
I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I did. They're just excited. They're exciting team. They're exciting guys. There's going to be one of them in there against Chris Jericho. I guarantee. Call him Lionheart. What do they call him?
Lionheart, Chris Jericho.
Lionheart.
How about it?
That's a good name.
I tell you, he's quite a young lion in the ring and has a tremendous heart about him. And that's why the nickname has stuck with him, because
I thought it was a long mane, hair looking like a lion.
Well, I'm sure that has something to do with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, well, who stuck that on him? Let's go and ask all
I
that.
Don't know, it wasn't me.
Yeah.
Here
yeah.
we go, Chris Jericho and Mark Bagwell. Should be a great matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc is almost here, and the talk is the mental state of the Macho Man Randy Savage. We've often said he's a nut. We know that he's a little bit different, but now he is very much upset. He's almost like all to himself. We'll talk to no one. Very riveting statement that you heard from Miss Elizabeth earlier on, and we're going to be talking more about that and see him in action a little bit later on in this telecast.
It was a very emotional interview and an emotional time to see this, and the look on his face and everything that's transpired. Here he is tonight against the guy they call Roadblock right here. But I got to really go back and say this Roadblock was set this past Monday night, if it's not true. She seems sincere, but always there's this question in the back of my mind when Hogan is concerned in that. Double drop kick, both of them miss, both of them pop right back to their feet because they did not make contact with each other. And remember, I feel about that, caught that right out the corner of my eye.
You sure did.
You thought I wasn't watching that match, but I was.
I wonder where you were.
All right, about the Macho Man, they said, there they go again. I'm telling you, boy, there ain't nothing like excitement at WCW where the big boys play. Go behind here on Saturday night. Got him wrapped up.
Look at this. A front chancery.
Look at this.
And a knee to the midsection. Jericho's got him caught in the corner. For Chris Jericho, he must realize that it's not going to be your basic matchup coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. Field him out of the corner that time. It is going to be a matchup where he must contend with Six, but the entire NWO. We saw earlier in this telecast, at least the fans did, we wouldn't watch it.
No.
The NWO segment where Six was in competition.
Yeah, but.
And it's very easy for them to win in their own environment.
Yeah. And that's been the way with them. They pick the environment they want to be in, and that's why the momentum is over in their court right now. That was a nice move right there by Jericho. But see, Jericho right here is in with a guy that's been former World Tag Team Champion and one of my favorite competitors, young men of all. We're talking about Marcus Alexander Bagwell. This is a major marquee matchup here on Saturday night. Going up top, high-risk maneuver. Man!
That was on target from Chris Jericho. Covering one, two. Boy, he almost got the three count, but at the split second, Bagwell kicked away.
Man, I'm going to tell you what, that was really powerful and quick.
A warning to get out of the corner by Mark Curtis, referee, up on top.
That time, Bagwell kicked it.
Yeah, he caught him right there good in the solar system, right down the middle.
Yeah, the solar system is good enough.
I'm going to tell you what.
It's good enough for everybody.
Yeah, and I guarantee you that people know where it's at home. If they ever had heartburn in the solar system, you know exactly where it's at, brother.
Oh, my goodness. A gut buster.
And they know where the gut is, too.
Yes,
a gut
they
buster.
Do.
Now, why is that not funny when you say it? Gut buster. I'm supposed to say, well, that's some serious reporting. You know what I mean? And when I say solar system, everybody in the truck is having a hee-haw out there. Whoa, duck under.
Down they go. One, two, three, beat.
Yeah, and that's only because the power of Jericho got the best of him coming off that thing. This was a good matchup right here. I like this young man, and I like Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Both men were trying the same thing. It's very obvious. It was Jericho's power that prevailed here. A disappointed Mark Bagwell, but hey, a great matchup and a great win for Lionheart Chris Jericho here on WCW Saturday night. And how about that? Good show of sportsmanship here. The fans love it. And Chris Jericho is... Well,
yeah, well, he
Bagwell didn't like it.
No,
did he?
He's not real sure about that situation. And Riggs is in there, you know, shaking hands and everything. This ain't no glad handing situation going on right here, because we're in the middle of a war going for this pay-per-view. You only buy this thing on pay-per-view. I'm talking about Slim Jim Halloween Havoc. You see off the top, Tony, right here, caught him flush. I thought right there was enough to put him out. Caught him flush. Now watch the power here. See here, boom. Momentum coming off the rope by Jericho. Gets the 1-2-3 on his way to another pay window right here on WCW Saturday Night with a big boss play. Listen, go talk. Tony's already gone from here. Another interview from the Silver Tongue, Tony Schiavone.
All right, Chris Jericho gets yet another win here on WCW Saturday Night. Next Sunday, Chris, you and six of the NWO, an added match, and I know you got your work cut out for you, not only because of what this guy can do in the ring, but because we're talking about a gang here, not only six, but all the members of the New World Order.
Tony, as everybody knows, the New World Order has been in WCW for a couple months now. They have never lost, they have never been tied, they have never been given a good run for their money. In Las Vegas 6, all that is gonna change, because Lionheart Chris Jericho is coming out of Las Vegas with a victory over you, and the New World Order is coming out of Las Vegas with the first chink in their invincible armor. Are you ready, 6? Because I am. Come on, baby!
All right, let's Chris go. Jericho is ready, and we'll be back with more Saturday Night right after this timeout. Saturday night, and before we see the Macho Man in singles competition with a lot on his mind, we're going to take you back now to the story of the Macho Man Randy Savage, his ex-wife Miss Elizabeth, and his ex-friend and now mortal enemy Hulk Hogan.
That's why this just does not sit right. And here he comes, roadblock. And believe you me, he is a roadblock.
I want to tell you what, this is a big man right here coming out here. You are so true. The emotional state.
the Macho Man Randy Savage might be the emotional state of WCW with the big boys play.
That's a good point.
I'm guaranteeing you, brother, it's falling down to it. We got a fighter coming, and it's right around the corner on pay-per-view, and I guarantee if somebody got to step to the plate and get this thing right. We got to right the mothership. I guarantee you.
And now the Macho Man Randy Savage.
I've been anticipating this thing for the last 2 hours. I guarantee I'm ready to get it.
In a real down state of mind ever since what occurred this past Monday on Nitro, but picking himself up here. Here we go on WCW Saturday Night.
You know, Roadblock looks to be a very big hoot there.
Randy Anderson coming up.
Well, there's going to be some controversy here. Don't tell me now what's going on.
What do you mean he left? I've been waiting my whole career for this.
Did you hear this?
He's gone?
I want to know where is
Ladies
he
and
too.
Gentlemen, we're getting word Macho Man Randy Savage was here. We saw him in the back, but you're saying now he left. He left the building?
The Macho Man has left the building.
Man, I'm going to tell you what, this is serious. Man.
He really is in a bad way, Drew. And that does not bode well for WCW coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. If he wouldn't show up, if he would leave at Nitro, if he wouldn't show up here tonight,
wow.
What's he going to do next Sunday? What if he...
I don't even want to think of that.
I don't either.
You know, you're bringing up so many what-ifs about that situation with him on Monday Nitro. You see this big tub here.
Where's he going?
He's going on the way back right here. I don't know. He picked on somebody sitting there in the back.
He's going to wrestle somebody. He's kicked this young man. I have no idea who this young man is right now.
Well, he jerked him right up and is taking him out. Whoa, baby.
That's Dusty Wolf.
Get out of here.
It is.
Dusty. Don't even mention the name Dusty.
Well, that's what he goes by.
No, there goes by. That's Scott Wolf.
Okay.
Scott Wolf getting thrown in the ring. Okay. Dusty Wolf.
Over the top.
Wow.
And Roadblock means business here. We are.
Man, I ain't concerned about Roadblock. I tell you what I'm concerned about is the Macho Man Randy Savage. Prepared to go into this contest right here tonight on Saturday night. Has left the building. Destruct. I guarantee you the world is watching this thing unfold in front of them because we have thrown it out on the street, Tony. Emotionally, we are not ready for Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc.
And it's almost here. It's not like it was a month away or 2 months away. It is here now. This big man is going to pin someone. And the only thing I can say is, fans, we have to take it to our next program here on TBS. We have to step out and see you tomorrow night on the throw. Randy Savage, where are you?
Yeah, he just left.
Where are you?
Hey, WCW, give me someone. Give me Lex Luger. I'll be here Monday. Looks like Randy don't want to show up.
You wrote the book on
Maybe
ugly.
You won't.
One of the worst choices I've made is signing with Hulk, knowing how self-serving he is and that he's using me to hurt you. I'm really lost, and I need you, and I don't think I can reach you. And I know that I feel the same way about you today as I did the day I said I'd do.